Before working for Doctors Without Borders, I worked at a hospital, which gave me some of the skills I needed to have in the field. Although I was doing something much more specialized, I was negotiating with pharmaceutical companies. So I understood finance and accounting and things like this. But when I first got my job description for my human resource and financial coordinator position, I had no idea how I was going to possibly learn all the things that they expected me, because you're definitely more generalized. I was managing a team of 10 in my first mission. We had 500 national staff. It was my responsibility to make sure that they all got paid. Luckily, the national staff is quite competent and was able to teach me as I went, but I had no idea when I first arrived how I was going to learn these things. You're also in charge of taxes and making sure the expats get their visas, the budgeting, to make sure you have the cash on the ground, to make sure payroll is taken care of, to make sure you can afford to pay all your vendors, all these things that in the hospital would have been someone else's job. Here with Doctors Without Borders, it was my responsibility. You have the staff to assist you, but at the end of the day, it falls on you if something doesn't work out. And if something isn't working, you're the one who has to come back and figure out a solution. You're always going to go back to your national staff and ask them what they think, but at the end of the day, it's your job. You're working with governments. Obviously, in the United States, I would have never had this sort of responsibility, but trying to figure out, okay, a visa was rejected, going to the ministry, how to make it work so that expat can get in, because if they're not there, if that doctor's not there, people will lose their lives. And while you're not a medic, as the HR finance person, you're a part of the bigger team to make sure those medics can do their jobs. On a day-to-day basis, some of the work is a bit more tedious. We're doing accounting entries. I've looked at so many receipts throughout my time with MSF, but to realize that the money is important too, and if you lose that and you're not paying attention, then it means that it can't be spent on patients, which is where it should go. So really, that's what I learned with MSF, is you have to be more of a generalist and kind of know a little bit of everything and know when to let your staff take over and when you need to step in and say, okay, I'll take on this responsibility. In the US, I worked as a hospital administrator. I was based out of the finance department, but I never once touched a dollar bill, despite the fact that I was buying many things for the hospital. Of course, we have every system is electronic, but when you go into these countries, you're not going to have that opportunity. Sometimes you're going a place where there is no bank. Sometimes you're going where the banking system doesn't work. So you have to figure out how to work around that. When I was in Uzbekistan, there was the government law required us to pay everything via the bank. So something as small as a pencil, you went to the bank and you did a prepayment for the pencil, and you went back to your office, and then a few days later the bank said the payment went through, and you went, you picked up your pencil, you went back to the bank, and you paid the rest of the bill. We weren't allowed to pay our staff with cash. Everything was via the bank, which, as you can imagine, is a large workload. Meanwhile, when I was working in Myanmar, there was no banking system, so every single thing was done in cash. We had 1,200 national staff in project locations across the country, so some of the flights were 4-hour flights, 2-day drives, and we had to pay them all with cash. And of course, the currency amounts, the denominations are much different than ours here, so you'd have desks and locks and safes full of cash that you had to figure out ways to get to the staff so that they could get paid, so that they could keep working, so that the patients could be treated. This is something I would never have to deal with in the United States, but you always constantly have to think of ways to get around these systems and to make them work so that everything is still being paid properly so the projects can run.